everyone. In this video, we will cover the current affairs. I am Nuzhat Sana. For mobile optimized ebooks, please install GK Today Academy app. You can attend the quizzes on this app for better practice. And after that, you can also read the detailed explanation of the questions you have missed. For regular updates, please check our Telegram channel. The link is given in the description box. You can subscribe to it if you find it relevant. For hard copy books, you can visit our website gktbooks.com. Okay. Also, our latest initiative is UPSC Prelims Test Series for 2021 and 2022 in GK Today Academy app. So if you are appearing in UPSC prelims, you may consider joining this. So now without wasting any further time, let's get started. So today we'll be discussing most important MCQs for 22nd June 2021. Starting with very first question, the crash course program for COVID-19 frontline workers launched by the Prime Minister is designed under which scheme? So recently Prime Minister has launched a customized crash course program for COVID-19 frontline workers, which would actually make available trained health workers across the country to assist the battle against COVID-19. So this comes under PM Kaushal Vikas Yojana 3.0, and the course has been launched with a financial outlay of nearly 276 crore rupees under the central component of Prime Minister Kaushal Vikas Yojana. Now talking about PM CARES Fund, it was very much in news few days back. Why? Because government has launched PM CARES for Children scheme, and this scheme is for all the children who have lost their both the parents in this COVID-19 pandemic. So as per data, 577 children are in this category. So they would be provided free education first of all, then there would be a creation of reserves of amount 10 lakh rupees, and it is for every child who comes in this category. And this amount would be given to that child at the age of 23 years. So this scheme comes under PM CARES Fund. Now recently we have discussed that Prime Minister has ordered audit of ventilators. What is it? Actually in this pandemic we have seen that central government has provided lot of ventilators and other medical stuff to the state government and the union territories. So it was seen that these ventilators were lying in the storage unutilized, totally useless. Hence, there was a need to have proper audit in the instruction and the operation of these ventilators. So, government has provided these ventilators to all the state government and union territories from again your PM CARES Fund. Question number 2. Varuna and Assi rivers, which were seen in the news recently, flow through which Indian state? First of all, why this thing is in news? Because recently National Green Tribunal has been reported discharge of untreated sewage in these rivers and unauthorized constructions on the banks of these rivers. So that's why now NGT has decided to set up a committee for rejuvenation of the rivers Varuna and Assi, which lies in Varanasi. So obviously it's Uttar Pradesh. And later on both these rivers joins the river Ganga. So now according to NGT, there would be a committee to take care of these rivers. Fine. Now UP was also in news because our new election commissioner, who is Anoop Chandra Pandey, belongs to UP. He is actually a retired IAS officer. Now also UP was in news because of its scheme, Affordable Rental Housing Schemes, and it is for students and urban migrants. So this will be implemented in two levels. The first level is to convert all your vacant houses funded by central or state government into an affordable rental house. And then second level is where public and private entities will build, operate and maintain ARHS on their available vacant lands. Now one more news from UP. Recently there a project has been started called Arjun Sahayak Irrigation Project, which is to be built on Dhasan River, which lies at Mahoba district. Question number 3. CSIR has tied up with which healthcare institution to ramp up COVID-19 testing in across towns and rural India? So recently CSIR has entered into a partnership with Tata Group's healthcare venture called Tata MD. What is CSIR? Council for Scientific and Industrial Research. So this partnership now aims to increase the COVID-19 testing capacity across tier 2 and tier 3 towns and in rural regions of the country as well. So under this partnership, Tata MD Check SARS-CoV-2 test kits would be extensively used to perform RT-PCR test across the CSIR labs in India. सो करेक्ट आंसर इज हियर ऑप्शन नंबर सी. नाउ सी एस आई आर वॉज ऑल्सो इन न्यूज बिकॉज इट हैज़ रिसेंटली अडॉप्टेड 295 अटल टिंकरिंग लैब्स अंडर अटल इनोवेशन मिशन एंड दिस विल हेल्प द यंग इनोवेटर्स हु आर एसोसिएटेड विद एट लैब्स टू लर्न फ्रॉम बेस्ट साइंटिस्ट ऑफ द कंट्री एंड ऑल्सो टू इन्हांस दियर थिंकिंग कैपेबिलिटी एज वेल एज इट वुड बी एन इंस्पिरेशन फॉर देम. ऑल्सो सी एस आई आर सी एस आई ओ वॉज इन न्यूज. कैन यू टेल मी वॉट इज सी एस आई ओ? रिसेंटली इट ट्रांसफर्स द यूवी डिसइंफेक्शन टेक्नोलॉजी टू कम्बैट दिस एस ए आर एस सी ओ वी टू टू 27 इंडिजिनस मैन्युफैक्चरर्स. ऑल्सो यू हैव टू टेल मी वॉट इज द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ एस ए आर एस. प्लीज राइट इन द कॉमेंट सेक्शन. क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. इंडिया हैज लॉन्च्ड अ ट्राइलेटरल विथ विच टू कंट्रीज फॉर इंडो पैसिफिक स्टेबिलिटी. सो रिसेंटली इंडिया अलॉन्ग विद इटली एंड जापान हैव लॉन्च्ड अ ट्राइलेटरल थ्रू अ वर्चुअल मीटिंग एंड इन दिस इवेंट इंडिया वॉज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय यूनियन मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एक्सटर्नल अफेयर्स. सो दिस ट्राइलेटरल एम्स टू क्रिएट स्टेबिलिटी एंड अ रूल्स बेस्ड इंटरनेशनल ऑर्डर इन द इंडो पैसिफिक रीजन एंड दिस वॉज बेस्ड ऑन कंसेंट ऑफ ऑल एंड नॉट द पावर ऑफ few. Now talking about Italy, it is the host for two events. First of all, it is the host of Global G20 Health Summit, which would also be hosted by European Commission. Then Italy is also host of COP26 along with United Kingdoms, and this event would take place in Glasgow, which is a city in Scotland. Now there was COP14, which was in news. Why? Because this time President Narendra Modi was the president of this event. Can you tell me what was the theme for this COP14? Please write in the comment section. Talking about Japan, recently Japan has decided to issue COVID-19 vaccine passport for all the Japanese travelers who are visiting the foreign countries for tourism purpose, or you can say business trips. It can be any reason. So this passport would not be digital but paper based. Now I am giving you a homework. Can you tell me the name of one such exercise which includes Japan as well as India? Do write in the comment section if you know. Question number 5. Kenneth Konda, who was in the news recently, was the founding president of which country? So recently Kenneth Konda has been passed away at the age of 97 years and he was the founding president of Zambia. So due to this reason, the government of Zambia has declared a 21 days of mourning for the former president. So actually Konda headed Zambia as a president since its independence, which was in 1964, and he was the president till 1991, but after which he turned into activism against HIV/AIDS in Africa. Now talking about some important recent appointments, Henry Marie Dondra was in news. Why? Because he is new president of Central African Republic. Then there is Rebecca Greenspan. She is the first woman official to head UNCTAD. What is this? United Nations Conference on Trade and Development. Then obviously new president of Syria is Bashar al-Assad. Then new prime minister of Israel is Naftali Bennett. And also there is one extremely important appointment, Ibrahim Raisi. He is the new president of Iran. Okay. Question number 6. Where is the headquarters of United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees, that is UNHCR, located? So it's none other than Geneva, Switzerland. And total of 22 headquarters are there in Geneva. Some important one are World Meteorological Organization, then there is World Trade Organization, UNCTAD, then there is International Labour Organization and many other. This UNHCR was in news in February month, I think. Why? Because in 2018, US had withdrawn from UNHCR, but now in February, it has again decided to join this organization. Okay. Question number 7. Antonio Guterres, who has been re-elected as the UN Secretary General, belongs to which country? So we have already covered this news few days back, that UN General Assembly has appointed Antonio Guterres as the UN Secretary General for his second term, and now the second term would be starting from January 1st, 2022 up to December 31, 2026. So for this president of 75th session of UN General Assembly, who is Volkan Bozkir has announced this appointment and administered the oath of office. So this personality belongs to Portugal. Can you tell me who's the president of 76th session of General Assembly, because he has been recently elected for this post? It's Abdullah Shahid. We have already talked about him. He is the foreign minister of Maldives. And this personality would be the new president of 76th General Assembly. And also, UN Secretary General has appointed Jean Arnaud as his personal envoy on Afghanistan. Question number 8. When is the Sustainable Gastronomy Day observed every year by the United Nations? What do you understand by gastronomy? Actually, United Nations define sustainable gastronomy as a cuisine that takes into account where the ingredients are from and also how the food is grown and how it gets to our markets and eventually to our plates and our bodies. Okay. So every year, 18th of June is celebrated as the Sustainable Gastronomy Day by the United Nations, and this day was first adopted by UN in the year 2016. Now, yesterday was the most important day because it was International Yoga Day, and the theme for this year was Yoga for Well-being. Now, there was an app which was launched by Ayush Ministry called Namaste Yoga, and it was launched to mark the beginning of series on Common Yoga Protocol, which is to be telecasted on DD India channel. Now, you have to tell me, when do we celebrate World Day to Combat Desertification and Drought? And also, do not forget to tell me what was the theme for this year. Question number 9. Which water body is also called the Gulf of Barbera? So the Indian Navy, for the very first time, it is participating in a joint exercise with the EUNAVFOR, means European Union Naval Force. And it is set to take place in the Gulf of Aden, which is also called as Gulf of Barbera. So this exercise would involve some of the most advanced air defense, then anti-submarine exercises, along with cross-deck helicopter operations. Recently, Gulf countries were in news. Why? Because Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar has held a meeting with India's envoys to Gulf nations. Why? To discuss various issues. Can you tell me which countries come under Gulf cooperation? And also, talking about some military exercises, there is Hand in Hand, which is a military exercise between India and China. Then there is Nomadic Elephant, which is between India and Mongolia. Question number 10. Who was the first Indian to win individual gold medal at the Commonwealth Games? So it's our favorite Milkha Singh, who is also called as the Flying Sikh. It's very sad to hear that he has been passed away due to COVID-19 at the age of 91 years. So Milkha Singh has won India's first individual gold medals at the Commonwealth Games in 1958, which was held at Wales. So Milkha Singh was a soldier and a track and field sprinter, everyone know, who had represented India in various international events and brought laurels to the country. Now, talking about some more important personalities who have been passed away, the first name among them is Sundar Lal Bahuguna. He is the founder of Chipko movement. Then there is Yuan Longping. Who is he? He is the China's top hybrid rice scientist. Then one more name is there, Dinko Singh. He is the Asian Games gold medalist boxer. And he has also passed away at just 42 years. Question number 11. Which chief minister is representing India in the Progressive International Summit for COVID-19 Vaccine Internationalism? So a 4-day summit by Progressive International for COVID-19 Vaccine Internationalism has recently begun, and it aims to provide vaccines for all the people across the world. So the summit will bring together governments, politicians, healthcare workers, vaccine manufacturers and different type of peoples like this from over 20 countries. So from India, Kerala Chief Minister Pinrai Vijayan, along with former Health Minister K.K. Shailaj, who is the representative of Asha workers, and vaccine maker Virtual Laboratories are participating in the summit from India side. Okay. Now recently, Kerala Health Department has developed Crushing the Curve, which is a mass vaccination drive. And also Kerala is important because it is the first state to become digital in public education, and also it is to develop new smart kitchen scheme. These news we have already covered in the previous lecture, so I am not covering the details of it. If you want to go into more depth, please refer to the previous lectures. Question number 12. RBI has approved which institution to take over Punjab and Maharashtra Cooperative Bank? So recently, RBI has granted in-principle approval of Centrum Financial Services and fintech startup Bharat Pay to take over Punjab and Maharashtra Cooperative Bank. So basically, in September 2019, RBI capped cash withdrawals and launched an investigation into its accounting lapses. So Centrum Financial Services is a subsidiary of the listed entity Centrum Capital. Also, Resilient Innovations Limited, which operates Bharat Pay, will be an equal partner in the small finance banks. Now recently, RBI has appointed its fourth deputy governor. Who is he? T. Ravi Shankar. Also, it has extended the term of M.K. Jain, who is already appointed deputy governor in RBI, for a period of 2 years. As we know that RBI has four deputy governors, so apart from these two, third deputy governor is M. Rajeshwar Rao and the fourth is M.D. Patra. Question number 13. Which union ministry formulated the draft national strategy for rural development? So this has been formulated by Ministry of Tourism. And this is an initiative towards Atmanirbhar Bharat, which is driven by the concept of vocal for local. So the Ministry of Tourism has invited feedback or comments or suggestions on the draft national strategy and its roadmap. Now, Ministry of Tourism was in news last year because of its initiative of Adopt a Heritage, Apni Dharohar, Apni Pehchan. So it was the joint initiative of Ministry of Tourism and Ministry of Culture. Why? To develop kind of synergy among all the partners to effectively promote responsible tourism. Why? To preserve our rich heritage culture by using our fundamental duties. So usually what happens is when we go to some tourist places, we see that on the walls there are various names written or there is this heart symbol out there. So this is totally not good. We must respect our heritage culture and try to preserve it as much as possible. So next time if you visit these places, if anyone is writing these things on the walls of it, please remind them their duties. Talking about fundamental duties, can you tell me which article of the Indian Constitution deals with fundamental duties? Please write in the comment section. Question number 14. What is the government's target to reduce road accident deaths by year 2024? So our Minister for Road Transport Highways, Mr. Nitin Gadkari, recently said that the government's target is to reduce road accident deaths by 50% by the year 2024. So he has taken this decision and announced it during FICCI webinar, which was on role of corporates in arresting road fatalities. So now the World Bank as well as ADB have sanctioned a scheme by which the government is allocating 14,000 crore rupees for states and NHAI to remove accident black spots. Now can you tell me the headquarter of ADB lies at which place? Coming to last question, which institution released the Global Assessment Report on Disaster Risk Reduction Special Report on Drought 2021? So this report has been released by UNDRR, which means United Nations Office for Disaster Risk Reduction. So as per this report, the drought has directly affected 1.5 billion people so far this century. So it's just more than any other disaster of this year. So this increased number is due to climate change, environmental degradation and demographic shift. And we celebrate our International Day for Disaster Reduction on 13th of October. Now let's start with today's quiz. Here on the slide you can see 5 questions which have been taken from the past 2-3 days current affairs. Here you have to pause the video and try to solve each of these questions. And at the end of the lecture, do not forget to share your scores. So that's it for today. I hope you have liked the session. These were the important news and events from today. And we will meet again tomorrow with some more important current affairs. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching. And please do not forget to subscribe to GK Today. With this, Meenu Zatsana signing off.